Alright, Microsoft just announced the new Surface Pro 9 with some cool and new features. We're going over everything you need to know as fast as possible, so let's go over the raw stats. The Surface Pro is Microsoft's premium 2-in-1 tablet laptop that's known for its practical design and superb performance. With the 9th iteration expected to follow suit with a starter price of $1,000 for the regular version and $1,300 for the 5G one. We'll discuss this in a second. But okay, nice price. Here's what you get with it. Form factor. For this year, we're going to see a similar design to the Surface Pro 8, including a 13.5-inch 120Hz display that will be great for most people. But we do get some new colors, which are pretty rad. Other features like the kickstand will still be included as well. But this all seems pretty familiar so far. What is new about the Surface Pro 9? Well, let's keep going. Let's talk about connectivity. There were no significant changes this year, which means yes. We still have a very minimal port selection that could most certainly be improved upon. Microsoft. Now, with this new device, we of course have the option to buy it with the Surface Pen, which is incredibly helpful and effective for students and professionals, with also some new apps to use with Windows, such as GoodNotes, originally from the Apple App Store. And for cameras, we'll be seeing pretty much the same thing again, a surprisingly good camera setup that is adequate for your needs, with allegedly some improvements plus new features such as background blur. But now, let's talk about the real news with this laptop. There are two versions, like I said, a regular one and a 5G. Yes, you now have the option to use your Surface Pro and stay connected wherever you'd like using cellular data. And that's pretty rad. So the non-5G version will use the typical Intel processor, while the 5G one uses an ARM-based processor designed by Microsoft and Qualcomm. And I'm curious if there will be any performance differences between the models, and if one is simply better than the other. But that's something we'll have to wait for the reviewers to find out for us. But all in all, yes, we get the new 12th gen Intel processors for the regular model, and an ARM-based one for the 5G option. Now, unfortunately, I do have some mildly bad news. The Surface Pro 9 will not have any changes done to its storage situation. It will start at 128GB, which is way too low for the price. I'm not going to harp on this for too long, but Microsoft has two things to really improve upon for the next generation: storage and connectivity. And maybe battery too. Last year's Surface Pro 8 was known for not having the best battery life, so I'm really hoping for an improvement this year. The Intel version will allegedly have 15.5 hours of battery, while the 5G one will have a whopping 19 hours. Which, okay Microsoft, not bad. The processors are more efficient, so that's fair, but I hope they included a bigger battery in this device as well. And finally, the laptop runs Windows 11. Let's get on to my verdict. So, what do I think of the new Surface Pro 9? Well, it's pretty good, though more of an incremental upgrade to the Surface Pro 8. So it's nothing crazy to write home about, but it's certainly something to take note of. The Surface Pro 9 seems like a good laptop for many users. But that is just how it seems. Let's see what reviewers think about it once they test it. But frankly, like I said, I'm really hoping for an improvement of the battery life of this device. The Surface Pro 8 touted a good daily battery, but that wasn't the case for many users. Like I said in my leak rundown videos, I'm hoping that this incremental upgrade will smooth out a lot of the issues we had with the Surface Pro 8. That way, when the Surface Pro 10 releases, or whatever the name is, we'll hopefully see some awesome innovation. But that depends on how well they iron things out with this laptop. So, who should buy the Surface Pro 9? Remember, it is a little pricey for many people, so this is a big decision to make. But I'd say it's great for students. The Surface Pro has always been a fantastic tablet-y laptop, and the Surface Pro 9 is probably going to follow suit. So many of my classmates use Surface Pros because they're just so good and so useful. But who else? Well, anyone who travels who needs a Windows PC. This laptop is one of the most perfect companions to your daily workflow. If you need to go to places and want a 2-in-1 tablet-y laptop, there are a few that I would recommend over the Surface Pro because Microsoft has been refining the design year after year. But even with that said, I would recommend waiting until reviewers get their hands on the device to test it out, and then you can make your decision based on your needs. So overall, the Surface Pro 9 is a seemingly fantastic 2-in-1 tablet-y laptop that's both practical and presumably high-performing. My name is Sears. It's spelled like Cyrus, but not like C. Rooster. Just take out the tur. Thank you very much for watching, and have a wonderful day. Peace.